Welcome back to part 2 of this tutorial series on making this ocean view scene. If you made it through part 1, great job. There wasn't anything super complicated in there, but if you're still pretty new, some of it may have been mildly challenging. If you had any questions or confusion, I hope you let me know in the comments of part 1, I'll be glad to help. For part 2, we'll add some materials and some lighting, and this scene will start to get more interesting. So with that being said, let's begin. Let's put the HDRI in first and see how that looks. We can find HDRIs on Polyhaven if you haven't heard of it. Polyhaven has free HDRIs, textures, and models. It's super awesome. If you ever have the opportunity to contribute something to them, I strongly encourage it. These guys are amazing. So you can browse HDRIs and then you can find anything that's like a sunrise, sunset. I used this one. So you can go into your world settings. And then for the color, right now you see this color is just gray in the background. If we go to viewport shading, we'll see this scene in Eevee mode here. And it's going to give us this HDRI. It's like a built-in one. If we want to just see what's in our scene right now, we can change this to scene lights and scene world. And now we just see everything in gray. If we change this color, it changes the color of the world. Instead of just a solid color, we can put an image in here. That image is an HDRI, which is like a wraparound picture, like a sphere picture that this scene will exist inside of. And that image will also provide lighting data, very realistic lighting data to everything within that sphere. So we will click on this color button and say we want an environment texture. And then we will go to open and find the HDRI that we picked from Polyhaven. And in this case, I use this Umlanga Sunrise 8K resolution. And it's going to take a second and it's going to put that in. And now we can see our scene. It's going to look even cooler when we put some more material in. Our objects are just plain white, so they don't look that cool right now. Also, to control how the viewport shading looks in shaded mode, we can go to this scene tab and change our EV settings so that ambient occlusion is on, screen space reflections are on. And then ultimately, we're going to render this in cycles. So we can switch this to cycles now. The viewport shading is still going to show it like this. Cycles will show it in more detail. It'll take it a second. It'll just make the lighting look a little more realistic with the shadows. But we will switch that back over. Okay, so now we want to bring our camera back and then look through it. I'm going to switch this back to solid mode. And then over in this tab, I'm going to switch these render settings to just... Actually, I'm going to set that to 16. Set the viewport to 16 as well. We want adaptive sampling on. And I'm going to put a little window down here that just lets me see my scene nice and small. We're going to change that to the 3D viewport. We're going to turn everything else off so we don't clutter our view here. Bring our camera back and we're going to look through the camera down here. I'm going to look at the camera properties and I'm going to fix the rotation here actually to 90, and I'm going to set this to 90, and then we're going to put that camera shift S, we're going to snap it to the cursor. And then we're going to drag it back on the X and up on the Z. And we're going to get a view something like that. You can see down here, this is what it would look like. We'll switch this back to our material preview. And then we'll make sure that in this window we see our scene lights and our scene world for the lighting. And you can get an idea of what we're looking at here. Now we want to rotate that HDRI because we want to see the water part of it where the sun is. We really want the sun coming through this window. So if we go back to our world settings, we can actually manipulate that HDRI, but not until we do a little fiddling with this stuff in here. So for the vector of this HDRI, we want to change this to mapping. That'll let us actually change the location, rotation, scale, and vector of this image. For this vector right here, we can just set this to generated texture coordinates. And now it looks like it did before, but we have the option to mess with the rotation. The z-axis is the only one we need to turn, and you see that image down there turning. We can aim this right at the water. Get that sunset in there. And then put this sun wherever you like. You can put it in that window, right in the middle of the door. You could put it on one of these windows. Whatever strikes you for the composition, put this sun wherever you want it. You can hold shift and move this in fine increments. Okay, now let's turn our attention to this window frame, and let's make this look like black metal. We'll click on the materials tab. We'll add a new material. We'll call this metal, and then we will raise the metallic value to 1, lower the roughness value to something low, and then we will change the base color to darker. Something like that. We can fiddle with it later and see if we want to change it, but that's a good place to start. Now the floor, this is where it has to start to get fancy. So I'm going to stay in layout mode and just pull a second window open over here. And I'm going to change this window to the shader editor. Okay. So for the floor, we need a new material. We'll say new, call it floor. And now we need a nice image of some wood. From sites like Polyhaven, CCO Textures, Ambient CG, there's a whole bunch of good free texture sites out there. I've acquired a variety of different wood flooring over time. There's a lot of awesome textures out there. I guess really you just gotta choose one that you like. For this project, I like this wood flooring 04. I just don't remember exactly where I got it from, so I can't point you directly to it. But if you go to like this 3dassets.1, you can find a ton of awesome flooring. I mean, you can see this type of shiny, rich, textured wood is exactly what we're looking for. And you could do tile floor if you wanted to do shiny tile. You could do rough wood, whatever you want. Ultimately, just pick a texture that you like. If you don't like what you picked, just repeat this process and pick a different texture. So I'm going to go with one that I already have. Over here in the shading window, I'm going to go Shift-A, add an image texture, and then I'm going to find that flooring one that I've got in this wood folder, this wood flooring 044. I'm going to plug that into the base color. And then we'll take a look down here and see what we got. And that already looks nice. It's a little too big. So I am going to press Control T, and it will automatically add a mapping and texture coordinate node connected to the vector input on this flooring image texture. Only if you have Node Wrangler on. If you don't, go to Edit Preferences, go to Add-ons, search Node, and then when you see Node Wrangler, turn that one on. Node Wrangler is super awesome. Now, we want to change the scale of the wood floor texture. And you can do that by clicking and dragging over all these and then changing the scale number. It's a little bit fiddly, and if you don't do them all, sometimes you're like, oh, I only change those two, or it can be a little obnoxious. A nice way to avoid any issues with that, you can see there's an input socket here. If we do Shift A input value and plug that in, we can control all three of the scale axes, X, Y, and Z, with a single value, which makes scaling this floor texture much easier. We can get something we like, and now we want to add the other nice parts of the texture to it, right? It needs some roughness, it needs some bumpiness. So we don't actually have a roughness map for this texture, which is fine. Let's just tweak the roughness of it right here. We'll just give the whole thing a kind of sense of shininess there. That's going to be just fine. Let's duplicate this. Connect the vector input. Let's change this to that normal map. Switch it to non-colored data. And then let's put in a vector normal map. Connect the color output to the color input, and the normal to the normal. And now we should have some bumpiness on that floor. We do. We can see the grain in there. Let's switch this to Eevee. The cycles view is going to give us a more realistic viewport render with lighting and reflection, but it's very slow. Obviously, you can see how slow the samples are filling in. So we will go into Eevee, and let's just move our camera right near the floor and get a grasp of this wood texture. Now, if we want more bumpiness, let's increase the strength and see how much we can squeeze out of it before it just looks kind of ugly and weird. That might be kind of cool. See, if you go too high with the bump, well, like 10 is the max, it starts to look kind of strange. You can dial it down. Get that wood grain that you're going for. That looks pretty nice. I like that. We're getting reflection in the floor, but it's not super detailed reflection. The lower we make the bump, the smoother that floor will be, and the more detailed the reflections will be. Bumpiness will break things up a little. Gives the wood a little character. So set that to wherever you like it. It's just really a matter of preference. So that's it. I mean, this texture is made of two things, the diffuse and the normal, and that's it. And that's pretty decent. And then we tweak the roughness. I mean, you can go so much further with these things, but the whole point of this tutorial is to show you how simple you could make something that's still a respectable looking render. Okay, that concludes part two. Thanks for staying with me this far. I hope you'll join me in part three, where we'll start to produce actual renders, tweak our render settings, do some compositing, and get closer to the finished image for this project. I know I skipped over some things in the interest of time. If anything was confusing, I'll be happy to elaborate. Please let me know in the comments section if you have any questions, and see you in part three.